A very good morning, my dear students. So we have come to an end the chapter understanding correlators. You know very well what is a correlator by now, and there are so many correlators out there that also I have taught you. Now, what is a correlator? Let me say once again. You divide this word correlator into two parts. One is quad, the other one is lateral. Quad means four, lateral means sides. So a figure which is having four sides, remember, it should be closed, is called a quadrilateral. Today, what I'll be doing, today I'll be revising. I cannot revise all the exercise today. So let me revise exercise 3.1 first. I'm going right from the first page and I'll be covering all the questions. So today I have got nothing to give you. I mean, no, I won't be giving any much study material on this. But what I have to say is, today I'll be going through each and every page, what is written here, because it's very important. Every textbook, not only maths, all the textbook, you should read each and every page, each and every line of each pages. Okay, so this is what I have done. I'm going through each and every page and each and every line. Read what is given there and try to understand. Clear? So this is a revision. So I'll be doing today only exercise 3.1, and tomorrow, if time permits me, I'll do 3.2 and 3.3. Let's begin this exercise 3.1. Okay. Okay, my dear students, let us start this chapter once again, understanding correlators. As I told you that I'll be revising this chapter once again with you. Okay. Now this chapter is very, very important. Clear? This chapter is very, very important, and first let me make you understand what are correlators, that you know what are correlators. But once again, suppose this word quadrilateral, if I write this word quadrilateral, let me divide into two parts, quadrilaterals. Okay, I have divided this word into two parts. This means four and this means sides. So what is a quadrilateral? Quadrilateral are those figures, or you can say it's a four-sided closed figure, are those figures which has got four sides and it is closed. For example, suppose I draw a figure something like this, they all come under quadrilateral. Clear? The sides may be equal, may not be equal, angles may be equal, may not be equal, but they all come under quadrilaterals as they have got four sides and the figure is closed. Clear? Now, there's a word here, plane surface. What do you mean by plane surface? The paper is a model for a plane surface. Here, this is a plane surface. Clear? Now, there's a word here, plane curve. What do you mean by plane curve? See, when we join points. Suppose I have a point here, 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 and here. Suppose I'm joining this point. Look at my pencil. I'm not lifting the pencil. See, I have joined these points. See here once again. I have joined all these points without lifting the pencil. It is called plane curve. Clear? Again, we have some figures here. What are these types? Simple closed curve, a closed curve that is not simple. Clear? This all comes under this type. So it's very clear what is a plane curve now. After that, we did polygons. Now, again, what do you mean by polygons? Again, there are two words here, polygons. Poly means many, gons means sides. Let us look at some pictures here. Now, here, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a polygon. This is a polygon. This is also a polygon. Let me tell you one thing. If I draw a triangle, that is also a polygon. Clear? But the curves that are polygon, why these are curves? Because we have drawn this line. I mean, this figure is drawn without lifting the pencil. But here, curves that are not polygons. See here. Why they are not polygons? See, it has come out. It is open here. It is open here. Okay. It has to be a closed figure of three or more than three sides. That is called a polygons. Clear? After this, we studied about the classification of polygons. Now here, number of sides or vertices is given here. Clear? Classification, that is triangle, like triangle, quadrilateral, pentagon. And after that, we had sample figures. These are the figures. Now, what are this? See, number of sides or vertices. If a figure has got three sides, it is called a triangle. Clear? And the figure could be like this. It can be bigger than this, it can be smaller than this. Clear? Now, quadrilateral has got four sides, so four here. Pentagon has five sides, and so on. We did this before also. Suppose a figure has got n number of sides. Now, what does it mean? N means it can have any sides. It can have 11, 12, 13, 14, we don't know. So, such figures are called. So, it is classified as n-gon. Correct? Now, after that we did diagonals. What are diagonals? See here, a diagonal is a line segment connecting two non-consecutive vertices. Now, these two are consecutive vertices and these two are non-consecutive vertices. So, when we join two non-consecutive vertices, we get a line segment that is called a quadrilateral. Clear? So, here SQ is a quadrilateral, PR is a quadrilateral. Similarly here. Okay. After this, we did convex and concave polygons. Now, what are convex polygon? All these figures are convex polygon and all these figures are concave polygon. So, what does it mean? It means when we join or when we draw a diagonal, they lie inside of the polygon. But in this case, suppose if I join these two points, these are two non-consecutive points. The diagonal lies outside. Here the diagonal lies inside. So this is a big difference between convex polygon and concave polygon. Clear? In convex polygon, the diagonal lies interior. These points are interior. All these are interior. So that such figures are called convex. Whereas here, diagonal lies outside or exterior of the polygon. After that, we did regular and irregular polygon. Now, what do you mean by regular? Regular means all the sides are equal. Irregular means all the sides are not equal. For example, let us take this triangle. It's a polygon having three equal sides. This is called equilateral triangle. This is a square because all the sides are equal. So, this is also quadrilateral where all the sides are equal and it is a regular polygon. This is also regular polygon because all the sides are equal. But in this case, here all the sides are not equal. Only the opposite sides are equal. Such figures are called irregular polygon. Okay. And this is also irregular polygon because here all the sides are unequal. You can see very clearly, you can see this side is not equal to this and this side is not equal to this. So all the sides are unequal. Irregular polygon, regular polygon. Clear? After this, we did angle sum property. Now, what does it mean? It means when we add all these angles, that is called angle sum property. Okay, for different figures, for example, the angle sum property of triangle is different, for quadrilateral is different, for pentagon is different. For different figures, we have got different angle sum property. I mean, the sum of angle is different for different polygons. Now, suppose if I take this this figure, let me count how many sides are there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 sides which can be easily divided into 2 triangles. Triangle 1, triangle 2. Now, we know very well the sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. This is also 180 degree. If I add this to what I get, 360 degree. That means sum of angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Now this is the angle. This is angle. This one is the angle. This one is the angle. This one is the angle. So it's very clear now sum of angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree because a quadrilateral can be divided into two triangles. For example, let me take this figure. Suppose this is a figure here I have drawn this. Now if I join this, what do I get? I get two triangles. The line is little crooked. Don't mind for that. But you think that is a straight line. So these are two triangles here. So sum of angles of this triangle is 180 degree. Sum of angle of this triangle is also 180 degree. So 180 degree plus 180 degree will give me 360 degree. That means sum of four angles. All these four angles. Even sum of all these four angles is equal to 360 degree. Let's take another figure. Let us count how many sides are there first. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry, the 7 figures, 7 sides are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, I missed out this. 7, 8. Alright, so there are 8 sides are there. Now see here, and each figure is a quadrilateral. Look here, 1, 2, 3, 4. They have mentioned the angles also here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. Sorry, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now see here, we know that sum of angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. That means 360 degree plus 360 degree plus 360 degree plus 360 degree. That will give me the sum of angles of this polygon. Or in a very simple way, we can do one thing. 360 degree into 4, we will get the sum of angles of this polygon. For all the figures, is same thing. Clear? Okay, after that we did question. After that we started exercise 3.1. Here it is. Now easily you can find out which are curve. Here are some figures which are simple curve, which are convex polygon. All these things we did, you can easily find it out. Let me take this question. This question was very, very important. Now see here, examine the table. This is the table is given, and you are supposed to fill up this. It's already filled here. Okay, now here, suppose. This is how many sides are there? 3 sides. Here how many sides are there? 4 sides. Here how many sides are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So sum of angle of this figure as well as this figure will be different. So one they have done for us. Here it is. Now see, they have done 4 minus 2 into 180. What is this 4? 4 is the number of sides. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 180 degree. They have multiplied into 180 degree. So 4 minus 2 into 180 degree will give me the sum of angles of this figure. Similarly here, 5 minus 2. What is 5? Number of sides of this figure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 minus 2 into 180 degree will give me the sum of angles of this figure. This is what we are supposed to do. Clear? Here sides they have given. Side minus 2. Clear? So this thing we did before also. After this, we did, what can you say about the angle sum of convex polygon having number of sides as 7? If a figure has got 7 sides, so what can you say about the angle sum property? It means what can you say about the total sum of angles of that figure? Clear? So what we are supposed to do is same formula, 7 minus 2 into 180. Clear? So what is the regular polygon? This thing we did. Okay, the same thing it is. Now all this we also did very nicely before. This is a quadrilateral, sum of angles of all these figures, of all these angles, 1 plus 2 plus 3, I mean this angles 30, 50 degree plus 130 degree plus 120 degree plus x is equal to 360 degree. Now find out the value of x, so easy. Let me take this figure. Now if you see here, there are two cuts. That means all the sides are equal. That means it's a regular polygon. If this is x, that means this is also x. This is also x. This is also x. This is also x. So how many x are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5x. So that means if there are 5x, so what is the sum of angles of this polygon? It's very simple. 5 minus 2 into 180. So I will get 3 into 180. That is equal to 540 degree. So x will be 540 degree divided by 5. So that will give you the answer. That is the value of x. Clear? Here also we can easily do this. Suppose you want to find out the value of x. The 120 degree plus x is equal to 180 degree. Because it's a linear pair. So subtract 120 degree from 180. You'll get this. Similarly, you'll get y. Similarly, you'll get z. But how to get this angle? See, once I get... See, after finding out all this, what you can do is find out this angle. How can you find out this angle? This plus this plus this plus this angle. Let this angle be E. A plus 120 degree plus 80 degree plus 60 degree is equal to 360 degree. Okay, you will get easily the value of A. Once you get the value of A, then you subtract from 180, subtract the value of A from 180, you will get the value of W. Here it is. So let me show you. See here, this angle. Suppose let me take this angle. 120 degree plus 80 plus 60 plus this angle I have considered as A is equal to 360 degree. Now from here you get the value of A, add this, subtract from 360. That value of A, again you subtract from 180, you will get the value of W. That is 180 degree minus A. I am writing in short. A means this value will come here. That value will give you the value of W. Okay, my dear students, I think the video has gone very long now. So I have just revised. I'm just making you understand, because this chapter is very, very important. Very, very important chapter. So that's why I thought of revising it once again. Okay, so let's go through this exercise. I have done only 3.1. Tomorrow I'll try to take 3.2 and 3.3. Clear? So let me stop here now. Okay, any problem, do let me know.